Oh. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death.
Hang on one second. Making sure these levels are all right. Test 1, 2. Hey, that delay's not so bad. All right. I think we can begin then. Hi. It's been a while. But it's time. It's time to finally crack open a cold one. And bust open Life is Strangle before the storm. Donnie Darko, walk with me. So, I'm pretty sure I have all this stuff set up, so I think we can just jump right in. Let's make sure, like, subtitles are on, because we're probably gonna want those. Okay, yeah. Alright, this works. Use the Twitch chat to talk to me. If anyone's gonna message at me or whatever. Alright, let's do this. Hype. So I'm hoping to at least get through episode 1 in this sitting. I might end up binging the whole thing. I don't know what's... There's a certain situation that's come up. I don't really know what's going on. So because of it, I got a bunch of free time. So I'm going to finally play this shit. What an edgelord. I agree. Piss. I mean, that's the only thing people do by train tracks anyways. Hell yeah, clean the shit out of that cat puke. It's a good idea. There's lots of diseases that cat puke spreads. Alright. She just looks like Max.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show.
Firewalk?
Fuck yes. Mom would kill me if she knew I was
out. That's the first line of this game. Oh, I'm so edgy. Look at me going down this park hallway. This is ridiculous. Oh god, what am I getting myself into? How does this control again? Oh, okay, let's look at it.
No
first.
Trespassing? No way.
This is too much already. Jesus Christ.
Holy shit.
Holy. Alright.
This place is awesome.
So we found the NASA.
If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Can't believe we found the NASA. Alright, what is... Can we look in this car? No? What about the edgelords over there? God, these controls are really weird. The movement of the character doesn't feel too bad, but this camera's too fast. It feels like, like, you know when you have that mouse acceleration thing on? It's like
if
that.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
Jeez. Alright, well, Damon Merrick, you lost on your Chewer v. Goldie. Chewer.
That's exactly your problem. Meaning you. Yeah, your
this
problem.
That RV?
Not mine. Shit. I know your kind. I know your bullshit excuses, too.
This is ridiculous.
Just slap those excuses out of you.
But it really wasn't my fault.
You're always blaming everyone
else. I like
else
how this teenage girl is just standing there watching them, and no one's saying shit.
Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
That slap was crazy.
I understand, really, and it won't ever happen again. I swear. You
Can I keep watching this? Is this new dialogue?
You really get it now. I do.
Do you? Because trust with me is earned in action.
This is such a stupid scene.
Got it.
Should probably avoid getting on that guy's shit list.
Is his name, I think. Let's take a look at the RV.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Am I gonna do some graffiti later? That's hype. Alright, what else do we got here?
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Yeah! Okay, I gotta stop. I'm sorry, this is bringing out the obnoxiousness in me because it's ridiculous.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years. I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends.
Okay, I gotta get...
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Okay. Oh, I got new dialogue. I guess... Wait, argument? Now this is just called argument.
Should probably avoid getting on that guy's shit.
Alright, so I guess that's for the...
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Bloodsport, taste iron, punk. This is some great graffiti.
Help you, miss.
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid.
Utah.
But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
They're supposed to break it. Or keep it.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him? An old lumber car.
Floral print bike.
Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
Let's try that floral print bike.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Those ear hoops. Oh my god, they're bad.
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Okay, let's take
Never
a gander.
Mind.
There's gotta be something else around here. I don't wanna do the cursing out meme, because I don't know what that's gonna do. Let's take a look at this bonfire. Maybe this we can ponder.
Some say
my favorite shit.
Alright.
It's time to ponder everything.
Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show.
In the woods.
This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere.
It's Fort Thunder.
Miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why
At
I'm
least
here.
It was before I fucked everything up.
Any place is better than home.
Okay, I guess it's time to stop pondering. Let's see.
Nothing says badass like
okay,
a nice floral print.
Is there anything we haven't looked at yet? Oh, wait, did we unlock... We unlocked a new dialogue somehow. Okay.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Okay. That doesn't help.
Never mind.
Okay.
Yeah, keep walking.
Was that a glitch, maybe? Either way, okay, we need to find something else to talk about here. What is this machinery?
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
This stupid song in the background. Okay, like I feel like they called attention to that gas can. Oh shit, I can write on the thing. Okay.
Ah, perfect place for me to work.
Probably a bad idea, but let's do it.
Now what to draw?
I'm putting my name on this. I saw Breaking Bad.
Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab. I'm sorry, officer. It says what on the side
of
my arm?
That's so funny! Alright, let's get out of here. I guess we'll just curse at the guy at the door. I wanted to try and do this another way, but I don't think there's another way.
Should probably avoid getting on that guy's
list. Just gonna say that every time I look at that guy. Alright. I truly don't think there's anything else for me to look at. Let me make sure one more time. Oh! I'm stupid.
A second door inside? So close, and yet so far.
Yeah!
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
I miss the way that they write this game.
That band shreds so hard.
Alright. You know what time it is? Time for me to do something that I might not be able to undo.
Keep walking, kid.
And you know what that is? Cursing out the bouncer. Alright.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
A backtalk challenge.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
Alright. Hi, Tricky Hero. How you doing? Alright, use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager?
Arguments and insults.
I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Uh-oh. We're having an argument. Succeed, pay attention. Isn't it past my bedtime?
I don't sleep. It's for the week.
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay.
Oh my god.
I get it.
This is a mess.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
This is out of control.
A girl like you with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle.
Oh my god.
I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan. Look, my boss decides who gets
who wrote this.
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer.
What a great battle.
Nope.
I mean, really I think that was kind of fun, but it was also all of those lines were fucking stupid.
Gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a
robot
motherfucking
ninjas.
Dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on.
All you gotta do is befriend the bouncer. That's how you get into the NASA. All right. Tricky Hero, you know, I kind of agree. Just a little bit, because I think she was being ridiculous. Like, every one of those lines was terrible and just not funny or witty.
This is intense!
Intense! Oh,
shit.
Whoa, Metal, come. they got a crazy dog.
Cute dog.
Whoa. This place is out of control. Question everything. Why? Alright, time to drink some beers, yeah. Drink with
just
me.
Follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Alright, time. Time to look at this
that
dog.
That dog is fierce.
Don't touch my soul with dirty hands.
What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither.
Alright, we've got a drunk girl over here.
Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
So am I. I'm just paying attention to NPCs. Where's the show even?
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing you up? I don't know.
This looks significantly worse than Life is Strangle did.
Don't you judge me, spooky deerhead.
Like, all the textures look like PS2 textures. It's sad, because I swear that Life is Strange looked a lot better than this. This is what happens when you outsource the game. They shouldn't have done it.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained to you.
Can I just take that shirt? I'm tempted.
Is that guy selling merch? Wish I had some cash.
I can't hear you.
That shirt is rad.
No.
Should I take it?
Look, we have to set this up exactly.
He's very distracted.
It's not gonna take any more than an hour to do it.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom
sweet knife
for my birthday.
Oh my god, shake your bony white ass.
Sketch Central. Sketch Central.
That mustache is out of control.
Okay, good.
Listen.
Right, well, $20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine. $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
Gotta come up with $20.
What's this?
Damon Merrick again?
Don't mess with Damon Merrick. What about this?
Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down in a
minute. These are the internal thoughts of a truest thief.
Releasing that brake would roll the car out from under that tool. Do I want a firewalk?
This is crazy. I'm gonna do it.
I think I do. Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
I mean, wait, is this Chloe or Rachel Amber? Whoever it is, Rachel Amber's dead.
No,
we know where Chloe ends up.
Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick.
What an asshole. When you want a $20 shirt.
Oh, yeah.
This is what I do at every concert I go to get free merch.
That's like $200.
Guess what time it is? Choice!
You're gonna see me take it.
Holy shit! I'm rich!
Well, this character's an edgelord right now. You know? You gotta be an edgelord. Alright, let's look at
nothing
this! Whoa!
Than a neglected bomb.
Whoa! What is this? Okay. This action will have consequences. ... Okay.
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
Right, it's time to... Oh my god, wait, what?
No thanks. I tried to avoid
holy
hepatitis,
shit.
But I can't. Frank Bowers? What is he doing here?
How do you know this Frank Bowers?
Hey!
Gone for true evil, yeah.
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot from me.
She's an edgelord, what can she say? You know?
Look at that getup. Studs, you're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
That's me.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
That dancing was pretty wild.
As soon as you give me the 175.
Oh, he caught me!
Toss in a dime bag and we'll call it square.
Hey, what are you waving around with this kind of money here for? You really don't think before you act, do you?
Nope.
Choice!
Where's my pop?
No more loans. How about your fucking piggy bank?
Yeah.
You're a good man, Frank.
You're a good man, no, Frank.
I'm not. Now beat it, Bryce. You're cramping my style.
I wasn't expecting him to actually be like, I saw that shit.
So, you come here a lot, or...
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
I'll see you later.
FCKPWR. Fuck power. Oh my god, this is crazy. Alright, let's check this back door. What do we got here?
Classy.
Oh, look. Porn! It's an M-rated game. Porn! Okay. I know.
Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey.
Well, that's the only way you're gonna see the band. Oh my god.
Graffiti everywhere. I think they missed a spot.
Well, am I gonna do this for
Sweet
real?
Sweet dreams, hombre.
Alright. Gonna get seen.
What are you looking at?
I like how she does this really blatant graffiti. Alright.
Damn, there are a lot of people here.
Who is dancing?
Here we go.
Alright, it's time. Woo, yeah, party. Oh, shit.
Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out
this
for
intro
you,
is really
bitch.
Bad.
Alright. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
I got some new dialogue, so I'm gonna talk to Frank about it.
She returns.
You see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Oh, I got you just talking to this random guy on the couch.
He works for Damon.
This random drug guy.
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Up.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? The floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Hard fuck core. QTEs, come on.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death.
This is crazy. Yeah. I like how you can hit circle to leave. But is she really laying down during a concert? Is she crazy? What is this? This is not how you act during a concert. At least this isn't how I act during concerts. I did this once during a Harry Potter movie at the theater, but not in a concert.
You spilled my beer, bitch.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
The fans like this nerdy weirdo.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer.
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some man.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Hey, dickhead.
Goth girl saves the day. That's Rachel Amber.
Come on. Hurry up.
This is a nightmare. This is really bad, but in a pretty funny way. Holy fuck. That was terrible. Oh god, is the whole thing gonna be like this? Like, is this what Fire Walk With Me is to this series? Oh god, this music.
Yeah, woke up, drank a beer. Yeah. I'm an edgelord. Yeah. Listen to those guitars. Look at that middle finger. Yeah, fuck you. Yeah.
This intro is so shit. Oh my god. So I can just chill here for a second? Alright, I guess that's what we're gonna do. So, yeah. This is it. We're here. This has been a long time in the making. I'm sorry for how long it's taken me to stream this, you know. I had a lot of stuff happen in my personal life. I've been going back to school and stuff. Hard to find time to stream this, but... I got a couple hours I can stream for you. I decided I'm gonna try to get through this first episode no matter what. Cause that's how this goes. I like to stream these in one sitting. There is a possibility something could happen that could cut the stream short, but I don't think anything is gonna happen. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. Either way, that do you see that milk carton that she's using as like a weed tray? That's crazy. Game is fucking crazy. So I guess I'm done rambling. I'm gonna let the song finish out and then we will continue. Hole to another universe. Yeah, this room. We're back. Back after all this time. Alright. We enjoyed smoking a doobie with Chloe. Now what are we gonna do? Is it the Clash? Is it playing the Clash? I love the Clash. Alright. Guess it's time to get up. Hey, Mel. So you missed a crazy, crazy...
Sometimes all I want to do is
crazy opening. It was really bad. There's like a some guy who's really pissed at her.
Rituals are important.
Oh god, we get some reading.
Even when they
yes.
involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
I didn't even hear that line because I was holy shit. All right. Here we go. I got to get ready for my big dramatic reading. This used to be my favorite part of the old streams. All right. Dear Max, Dad got me the stationery one day when I complained about wanting to send an email and the internet was down, and tonight I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. The funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't talked in 3 months, despite all my calls and texts, and not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe the Unfriended. Now, this is more... Oh my god, that's a weird... Put your thoughts in me. I don't like that drawing. What does that say on the shirt? New okay CNVGF. Yeah, I don't... If anyone can decipher this puzzle, let me know. Now, this is more like it. Here I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Maybe one day when you return home and apologize for having forgotten about all about me and we kiss and make up, I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide that Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max, and you'll just live in here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend pen pal. Time will tell. Chloe, the journal boss. These are some creepy letters. All right. Let's see. Yeah, you're the edgelord this time. So that's why I was making edgy decisions. Like, I stole $200 and a t-shirt. And I pushed someone, I released the parking brake on someone's car so that I could steal the t-shirt, and the $200 was a bonus. And then I spent the $200 on a tiny bag of weed, because that's what this game is about. Anyways, ready? So Mom suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David. The wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mom and is stuck around like a bad zit. David, the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That fucking David. Anyway, I politely suggested to Mom that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by then, or breathing. Hey, shit happens. As you might imagine, that didn't go over well. And we got this poster for the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit, because she thought she was real funny when she made that joke, so she opened up Photoshop. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues, and I've got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plans. She can do better. That's all I meant. But she didn't want to hear it. Like, I'm the asshole. Chloe the asshole. We have this drawing of a future Chloe. Oh, God. Okay. Max. So, you know, this. She's, like, obsessed. Holy shit. So you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't. I just didn't show up. And it was fine. Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's the perk of being the dead dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figured this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Pris from Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard and that smolder of his, but then Pris totally stole the show. Probably nothing there. Think I just want her bangs. Chloe the Electric Sheep. Jesus Christ. Okay, and we got one more. We got one more letter for you. Jesus Christ. All right. Max the Loser. This cutting out letters thing is really creepy. Yeah, oh, and we have the firewalk thing. Alright, yeah, that's right, I called you a loser. Want to know why? Because you weren't at firewalk last night. Even Frank was there. He's my dealer. Or Mom. If you're reading this, he's my dealer and you shouldn't be reading this. It was maybe the great... No one is in Blade Runner as I'm turning this off. Agreed. It was maybe the greatest night of my life. I hiked to this old mill using the train tracks, then verbally abused this dumb bouncer until he let me inside. Firewalk was the shit. Who knew ragers like that went down at little old Arcadia Bay? Fuck Seattle. Plus, I almost got my ass kicked. The 8-bit music notes, too. Everything about this is a train wreck. NBD, but there were these two asshole skeevy guys whose manhood I wrecked. Oh yeah, and I got rescued by the most popular girl at school. How was your night, loser? Firewalk plus Chloe is better than Max. And that's it. That's what we get. This is a creepy... Oh my god, we've got these too. Okay, I'm sorry about all the reading, but we'll be done soon. Okay. My name is Chloe Price, but you can call me... Middle Finger? Is it referring to the stupid picture? That's... If anyone ever writes that in a book in my presence, I'm gonna... That pisses me off. Anyway, I'm an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently serving a 4-year sentence for crimes against maternity. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me. Which, I get it. I'm no one's image of a perfect daughter or student or anything, really, but who the fuck wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection and it sucks ass. Other things that suck. Mom's new drill sergeant boyfriend, David. How hard it is to buy weed around here. Having no friends, hypocrites, country music, people who say chillax, dad being dead. It's been 2 years since he died in a car crash, and I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weirdly lifelike dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times, I remember that he's feeding worms in a ditch right now, and anything else is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. Oh my god, that middle finger. Is that a sticker? If that's a sticker, that is incredible. It's not a sticker, but it's fucking incredible is what it is. Or maybe it is, I don't know. Anyways, where was I? It's just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. At least I have two, and she drew the worms, what a weirdo. At least I have two weapons to help me survive this shitberg town. The pin I use to tag any and everything I want, and my shining personality. Oh, by the way, that was another thing I did in the intro, Mel, was I did like all this graffiti everywhere. It was ridiculous. If I work in it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. This is a screenshot, okay. Alright, we gotta learn about the drug dealer man now. For a drug dealer, Frank Bowers is actually pretty chill. He likes to act like he's a tough guy, and I have no doubt that he's done a few messed up things over the years, but to me, he's like a scruffy dog. The tougher he tries to come off, the cuter he seems. And then we have this stupid dog bowl with his name on it. I've been buying weed from Frank for close to a year. I almost never have enough money to pay him, and he always tells me, it's the last fucking time, Chloe, I'm not your fucking friend. Then he always gives it to me anyway. Like I said, guy's adorable. Of course, if I even did anything to actually get on Frank's bad side, he might not seem so cuddly anymore. I hear Frank rolls with some dudes who are into way darker shit than keeping high schoolers medicated. I agree, Mel. You gotta make a journal like this, and then you could, scan it. Alright, let's see. This is the best journal I've ever seen. I love this stupid drawing at the bottom of the left page. Actually, that's the kind of stuff I draw in my shit, but anyways. It's hard to imagine Frank getting mixed up with anything really bad, but I guess you never know. For now, I'll just keep hoping that Frank is even worse at remembering who owes him money than he is at being intimidating. And we have D.O.B. old. Alright, that page sucked. We got salt and pepper and a punk rock benefit show poster. Alright. Despite my mom's best efforts, I don't actually hate her. I know shit's been rough since Dad died. Money's tight. Her job as a waitress at the diner isn't exactly glamorous, and I'm clearly not all about the whole going to school thing. But why does she have to make things so much harder on the both of us? She acts like if I smoke pot or when I skip out to go catch an awesome show, it's somehow a personal attack on her. She should be happy that I'm self-medicating and not going postal on everyone. She never used to be this way when Dad was around. She could actually be pretty cool. but lately there's a hairy dick monster she let into the house that's fucking everything up. David Madsen, a jobless, brainless, dickless little shit with a hard-on for the military and a promise to whip me into shape, asshole. I've tried to express these concerns to my mom, yet every week it seems the virus spreads to yet another corner of her life. I'm starting to worry about that the David flu is the kind of disease that kills its host, and here we have a dick tank. This game's fucked up. Alright. It's the crazy guy. That's right. Max Caulfield, MIA ex-best friend extraordinaire. This artsy motherfucker loves photography more than life itself, and definitely more than me. She even uses old instant cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be that stuck in the past, but who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we would dress up like pirates and eat ice cream and write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and save people and shit. And we got the comics here on some post-its, except you can see one of the post-its is bleeding over onto the other one. It doesn't make any fucking sense. Super Kitty is trapped. We must save her. Or maybe it's highlighter. Maybe the each panel's they did highlighters over it, which is equally stupid. Meow! Oh my god, that sound was crazy. Alright. Then my dad died, and her dad got some job up north, and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her most, and she bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned. The worst part is that even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she habitually ignored my text so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore and that she probably has all new friends up in fucking Seattle, I still miss her. If she came back tomorrow and said, "Hey, Chloe, want to dress up like pirates and be stupid together?" I would take her back in a heartbeat. Lub dub. In a heartbeat. And then there's Pirate Max. Hey, Chloe, this is a creepy journal. If I had a nickel bag for every jerk-off guidance counselor or therapist who tried to get me to write shit about Dad over the last couple of years, I would never have to buy weed from Frank again. What's the matter? Don't you want to write about your dear old Dad? What is that picture? That picture's creepy. I guess they think it helps me cope with my feelings or whatever, as if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are probably still plastered to the underside of a semi-truck. And what the fuck am I supposed to write anyway? That he was the perfect dad? I can't do this. Who was always fun to be around and never angry, that he treated me like an equal, that he was constantly working to make our lives better, that he could always make me laugh even when I was being a bitch, and that he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy, and that his barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard because the thought of either throwing it away or never using it again are both so painful that it's easier for Mom and me to just pretend neither of us notices it. Here lies. If that's coping, then coping can go fuck itself. Yeah, this journal is really bad. Like, the tweets on a private account, I don't know. This is... Alright, we're done. We're caught up. So what else have we got? We've got our graffiti. So that's what this one's photos are, is drawing on shit. So I gotta do a Lost Unicorn, David shit, prison wall, drama nerds, moving canvas dead, white guy, happy brat, and the old car. Okay, do we have anything else? We just found this. So someone lost $1,000 and owes. No, journals are cool. Journals are cool. This is how you don't do a journal. Alright. When I get to the top, I go back to the top of the slide. Then I stop and I turn and I go for a ride. What do I do? Am I supposed to look for something? Oh, I look at the photo.
Hey, hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Do a handwritten journal and,
write
it as if someone else is reading it, so that way...
Last night...
Like, be honest, but don't... Don't write stuff that you're embarrassed about.
The skeet
like, super embarrassed about.
That...
That's how to do a journal. Then it doesn't turn into Chloe's journal.
Is that really Rachel Amber?
I don't know. It looks worse. It's like PS2
tier. Smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. That really was
Rachel Amber. I'm gonna take as long as possible.
And she saved my life.
Oh, Rachel Amber was like a goth punk girl. It was crazy.
I'm gonna use the
Ask
computer.
Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. 87.9
FM, the Seder, supported by she did. She was she's too drunk to change clothes. All right, dear Miss Arcadia, did you hear about Firewalk coming to town? I checked all the local venues, but nobody knows anything. Sergio 22, not all the local venues apparently. Dead fan. Don't know, but bumping the thread. Rand. Okay, gents, here's the scoop. It's a private party. Not as in you're not invited. More like you're better off staying away. And I know that just made some of you more into it than ever. So proceed at your own risk and abandon all hope, all ye who enter. Ever heard of the mill? Miss Arcadia. Bump. Thanks, Scourge. Oh shit, if you go, don't look anybody in the eyes. If you look anybody in the eyes, don't look away. If you look away, why would you start listening to my advice now, Rand? Haha, look at my eyes. My eyes are alien. Great movie. Is that Warren, the doctor? Jesus Christ. What are you talking about, Firewalk River? Not of this earth, only the original, though. The doctor. Oh, I see. What's the mill? Firewalk River. That's adorable. Previous topic, Prescott's and the Illuminati. Next topic, Heishi Earthquake Relief Fundraiser. I hate this. Wait, social media
what?
Shit.
Who?
Victoria Chase?
What photo?
So we have some returning characters here, you can see, on nodface.d9. That's my favorite website. Tell me what's there.
I have feelings about this.
Oh my god,
most
it's Google Hangout.
Most of them are not good feelings.
Firewalk, jealous, you look hot. Who's the arm candy? Deborah something. Deborah Borgen, I think. So fun, kisses. Glam, get it, girl. Who's Deborah Borgen with Rachel in the picture? Ugh, Rach, you're so gorgeous. I hate you, XOXO. And who's Armand? Dude, that's Chloe Price. Taylor, wasn't Rachel invited to your sleepover last night? I was wondering where she was. Burn. This is some terrible fucking writing. Oh no, I didn't mean it like that. So much fun. This is a really intelligent conversation. Yeah, this is a prequel. It's a...
One of these days, I'm actually going to use you to do my homework.
Isn't someone knocking on the door telling me to leave?
I'm so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair.
What is this? Exploding of sharks. What's this bear?
Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear.
Oh, God.
Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid, but then all the unicorns died.
World of Warcraft. Later, Tricky Hero. Thanks for watching.
No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking
rooms. Was it? I forgot it was even in Breakfast. I was just like, what is this?
Words of wisdom, don't fail me now.
What? She's gonna write one of the edgy things. I think this is the one that's on it in the game. It sounded familiar. You miss 100% of the shots you don't drink. I think that was it. Let's look at
Fun
Mr.
Facts.
Sharky.
Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
What's in the drawer?
Max made this
mixtape
years ago.
And the CD looks lit, actually.
Not a single song was pirated.
What a weirdo.
It's
put
awesome
back
that
up
some of those
fucking
shows
unicorn.
Were. They were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
I saved all of these. You have to delete that photo of me dancing, haha. Only you could get me to loosen up like that. Happy 2-month-versary, Elliot. Who? Who's Elliot? Someone tell me who Elliot
Mom
is.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome.
Noravi! The white blood transfusion.
I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation.
I have no fucking idea who Elliot is.
How do I want to express my teenage angst today? I bet Long Matt Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago.
Shake that bony white ass.
Man, I am killing it this year. Somehow I don't think Mom's going to feel the same way.
Alright, she's being difficult and unfocused and disruptive. Time to throw this away. Be smart.
Yeah, no one needs to see
hide
that.
Evidence.
Thank you.
Alright.
Let's see, we gotta look at this,
I'd like to think my humor has improved with age.
Why can't you be more positive? Alright, you know what time it is? It's graffiti time. He's just gonna draw a big dick on it.
Better living through chemistry.
Wow. That's even worse. That's even worse! Get me out of here! Alright.
Wake and bake is part of a healthy breakfast.
Okay, 420.
I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually.
Alright. I needed some silence to get my thoughts together after I get dressed. Oh my god, what the fuck are we in for? I have a choice here, do I? No, I don't. I don't have a fucking choice. Wait, I do. Bonus outfits? Illuminati? What's Illuminati? What is this shit? Pre-order bonus content. Okay, let's do it. This looks so stupid. I hate it. Doesn't work without the blue hair. Wear it to cop Illuminati tank. Why did it take so long to do that? I don't know. Let's go with the firewalk tee. I don't want to fuck with these. Let's just go with this, because this makes sense in the context of the story. She went and saw a firewalk, now she's got a new shirt. That's it. It's a shirt she stole. Alright. Alright, so here's the deal.
Without my vitamins.
Without my vitamins? Are you crazy? Don't take that with you, you idiot. Choice! I made the choice to get that. Now she's making a bad choice.
Yeah, I really should keep going.
I'm gonna pause really quick because I need to use the restroom. So, bathroom break. Bathroom break time. Alright. Ultra Death. What is Ultra Death? This rejected thing is crazy. Alright, give me just a second here. Okay. Alright, let's continue. I think this is a good time to continue. I hope everyone's back from the bathroom break of a lifetime. Alright. I don't think there's anything else in here for us to look at, so...
Shit! Where's my phone?
Oh.
It's not here.
How drunk was I last night?
You left Donnie, it when you stole the shirt.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out...
Home, sweet home.
Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to.
Okay.
Let's open the drawer. What do we got? Condoms?
Yes!
Mom!
I knew it. That was extremely predictable. Oh my god.
Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign. I should call my phone.
The Apple iPhone.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Wouldn't that be the dream? That head shake. She just does not approve of this. All right. I mean, honestly, like, I'm thinking about even when I was a teenager, like, what was I expecting?
Like, sounds like my phone is definitely
I don't know.
Nearby.
My parents were really reasonable with me, but I was really... Wait, can I take things? Are there things I can take in here?
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
I'm gonna leave that phone ringing while
What's
I do
the matter,
this, because it's funny.
You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend?
It's funny to just leave the phone ringing in the background for, like... Oh god, this is a crazy thing I'm doing. I'm a little tormentor.
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
This music. She's grieving, you asshole. Choice. I can't take this seriously, I'm sorry. Okay. Oh, my phone's on the desk, okay.
I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of them. I can't believe I used to sneak in there
oh,
for
never
her
mind.
Makeup.
I thought it meant ring is in Mom's ring.
Mom's old engagement ring. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn.
Is that taken with a 0.01 megapixel camera? I think so. Alright, we gotta go get our phone. Jesus Christ. Did I leave it in the pisser? Yes, I did.
Ugh, I drank way too much last night.
Or was it just dinner?
There we go.
Trying to finish that line
Wonder
for
Wonder how many calls I've missed.
All right, Mom and Elliot. Will you be joining us for supper? No, thanks. Will you be coming home at some point? Will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences! Choice! Except I didn't make that choice. The game made it for me. All right. Is this the BF? Spanish test suck. Lucky if I passed. Aw. Lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What you up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Oh, okay. You finished the chem homework? Nope. Dude, that's the third time. I already know everything. I don't... Oh, look. Your shit's here. Hell yeah, but tapped out. Sorry. Your loss. Hey, can you hold it for me today? Can I? I'm your favorite customer. Are you? Frank, you holding? You still owe. You gonna have me whacked? Yes. Please joke about that over text. I mean, you deal drugs on this phone. Anyway, come on. It's 420. I'll meet you if you have the cash. Arg, rain check. What an asshole this Chloe person is. All right. Maybe she was always an asshole. Okay. So sorry I've been bad about emailing. Texting is better for me anyway. Yo, it's Max. How's it going? You there? Gah, sorry again. I've been really busy. You'd love Seattle more in a bit. Cool. Maybe some hitchhiking in my future. Hey, hippie.
I'm so sorry, maybe we should set up a time to call. No worry, I'll check my dance card. 7 p.m. in Arcadia Bay. What is it, 2019 in Seattle? I know, right? Maybe this weekend. Sure, anytime. Let me know. Yo, King of the Crickets, what's the latest, Max? Jeez. Cold. Ice cold.
Breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
I like how long-winded this entire thing was. What if I just left without getting the fucking purse? Ah, I'm gonna steal your purse. Ah.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone, too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah. Yo, it's Max!
That really makes me want to hurry.
Alright.
Coming, Mom.
I wish there was some loading music or something. Like, this sucks. It's just so awkwardly dead silent, so I have to fill it by rambling for an indeterminate period of time.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Those are streaming tactics, by the way, if you want to have a nice, engaging stream with your audience. All right. Let's take a gander
here. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
I wish I could just leave. That'd be funny. If I could just bail. I mean, I wouldn't want to miss content, but...
Mom calls him just a friend.
Look at him. Investigate Arcadia
Bay. Pretending he didn't just spend the night. And you never saw the condoms, Chloe. You never saw the condoms.
I made a choice to open that drawer and predict what was inside. Alright, before I talk to Joyce, I'm gonna look around here. What do we got?
Haven't really felt like sitting down to eat since David started having dinner here.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
The way she set that down was crazy.
She strokes out. Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole.
Shipyard closing. Though real estate developer Sean Prescott promised that employee layoffs would be minimal when he purchased the shipyard, he announced this week that he will be ending operations effective immediately. In a move not surprising to longtime residents of the region, the Prescott Foundation also liquidated the Arcadia Bay Stevedore Association's defined pension plan. Michelle Kinsey Robertson, staff attorney for the foundation, defended the action as our right in recouping unrecovered losses against debts owed. Sean Prescott could not be reached for comment. All right in recouping unrecovered losses against debts owed.
Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is the best newspaper I've ever seen. A wildfire warning has been issued for all residents of Arcadia Bay. Fines doubled for illegal fireworks and campfires in unauthorized areas.
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you.
That's so
also
funny.
Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Was that supposed to be a David Lynch voice at the end? Never mind. Don't... That was a dumb joke. Arcadia Bay Gazette, tuition hike. Let this be emphatic. This is not due to financial woes, says Presidential Ray Wells. After a survey of the tuitions of prestige academies of similar caliber, we are simply keeping ourselves competitive. Thanks. Blackwell parents invest in their children, not their vacation homes. Wells further emphasized that in addition to merit-based tuition awards, this year won by sophomores Stella Hill and Brooke Scott, the school's program of need-based scholarships remains in place for students who maintain exceptional academic records. Okay, this is... I hate that picture a lot. What else can we look at? Just gotta keep her waiting.
Right there with you.
Ah. Letting out the teenage angst on the snow globe.
The little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Oh god, I hate all of that. I hated that whole thing. They shouldn't have put it in the game.
Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5.
She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist.
Wait, those aren't Mom's keys.
I don't know why.
And
wait.
These would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom.
Wow, am I gonna do some...
like his home, maybe?
Crazy shit with these keys? Can I? Oh, I thought I was gonna, like, hide the keys.
It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so... nobody's fault, really. From when Max and I spilled
Mom's wine. I like how I'm just
wine.
Stalling so much. Like, she's just like, please hurry up and talk to me.
So
and I'm just like,
mad at me.
I'm looking at stains on the floor, Mom.
We're already supporting one. Thanks.
God, Chloe's such an annoying edgelord. All right.
Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything.
Uh-oh.
Like, I need another reason
she's
for principal
She's been cooking scrambled eggs for, like,
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in, like, a year.
All right. Is there anything else? We got some more dialogue that we can use when it's time to be sassy.
Dad always talked about upgrading.
We got
to
that
a flat
mark
screen.
On the wall. I think we're done after this.
Too bad that never happened.
Oh, and we got that photo.
I would have gotten this bad boy in my room. Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
And never looked back?
Captain Chloe Bluebeard, Scourge of Arcadia, with her first mate, Long Mac Silver. This is just a very creepy game. Alright. I think we've looked at everything. There's not a thing in here for us to look at that we haven't already looked at. Is there a bird that's gonna die? Oh, it's a swear jar.
Dad's
We're gonna have to
swear
put
jar.
30...
He spent the last of his curses
this
on
This is a cool game.
Milk.
I mean, I don't know. It's both. Like, I love Life is Strange.
Smell so good, but I'd still
this is a mess, but I'm having the time of my life playing it, which is basically how I felt about the first one. And I think that in the end,
Mom
I would argue the first one was really good. So,
Joyce Price, aka Mom. She looks as beat as I feel. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not
Heck
always
is right.
in the mood for diner-type food.
All right, it's time. It's time to back talk.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to
I guess
answer.
It's time for beer number three.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
I should have pretended to be asleep.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Now I'm a southern mama.
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot
right
roast.
About the eggs?
I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? Ah, right.
More eggs!
My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't
XD.
Joke like that.
Ah, she's so edgy!
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my
Where
being,
is she
right?
stashing all the
Chloe.
Eggs?
You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
Oh,
he can
hang
be
on one
old
second.
Fashioned.
Yeah.
What?
An old fashioned dickhole.
Well, I can't right now.
Okay, Roger door.
Okay. All right.
Are you selling your engagement ring?
I was getting a massive
jewelry
prank.
Gets appraised for all sorts of reasons.
It's okay.
Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
What did I miss?
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then?
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
I missed that entire conversation because...
Oh, you'll enjoy
this. I told my dad I was streaming,
but he's
still...
The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, What are you gonna eat?
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewalk? Is that the band the you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
Where'd you get that shirt?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just
because
you
missed the bus again. I like how I fucked myself over.
Why would you assume that? Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just
so
you don't get
upset? It's so cringy. That's just called firewalk.
And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship.
No, we'll never stop.
Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
David's really not that bad, if I remember correctly.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his
experience. I'm using your name in a derogatory fashion.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
I got you!
When he takes you to school today.
Very
How could
funny.
You be so heartless?
You will be nice.
All right, beer number three time.
And you will say thank you.
Are you serious?
Sora!
This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
I'm gonna be understanding.
Mom.
Yeah, listen to that music, yeah. Where's my guitar?
I understand you don't.
I guess that was it. I thought it was gonna burst into a song.
But I need you.
Chloe, stay focused.
You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
I was gonna try to get that guitar. I was jumping up. I wasn't. I was ready for it. I got a new sticker I gotta put on it too.
Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it.
I've been playing my guitar much.
Unless he tries to give me advice.
It's bad.
Or looks at me funny.
I gotta get together.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
How could you be so heartless? Alright. It's time to get those keys and, I like how she acts like the keys are disgusting.
No point in putting off
They're keys, you fucking weirdo.
David. It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault, really.
Uh-oh. Hey, is this Chloe? This is Steph Gingrich. Hey! I have your DVD. You can get it before school. Thanks! Alright, is there anything new in any of these? I don't think so. Alright. Here we go. It's time to leave. A lowercase t for time to get out of here.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
The car is cool. Chloe, you don't know what you're talking about. You just shut your stupid
Why
mouth.
Why do women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
She's extremely rude. You know, I liked Chloe in Life is Strange, but I don't like her in this one. She's a little too much.
Repeatedly.
Understandably so, but still, like, fuck. And then again, I'm making her be an asshole with my choices, so I guess I,
you know what a spark
club
does?
It's all me, but,
yes.
You know,
did
you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
Grab my socket wrench from the garage.
What is this? Quality time?
A socket wrench. Ugh.
Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. Mom should date literally anyone else.
I bet I can do something edgy
Where's
with this
car.
Where's
the socket wrench set again? All I see in the garage is family stuff. You know, not your stuff.
Who wrote this?
Stick around on your own time. It's in the toolbox. In the garage. Won't be late to school on my watch.
I knew it was you, Vixen.
School's hardly worth walking to.
I knew it was you. And you will pay for this. Alright.
Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something?
I mean, this is a masterpiece, all right. Yeah.
By toolbox, did David mean this, or did he mean himself?
I gotta stop that, but it's out of control. All of this is. The sockets.
There's his stupid socket wrench set. 50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
That sound is crazy. Oh my god, are you serious?
If it's in my garage, it gets my special treatment.
Time to write on this. Really he'll never know hear. Who wrote it.
it.
Oh god. That's so stupid. This is a box of dicks instead of tools. What's in my thing? Yeah, here we go. Okay, so we gotta get a prison wall, drama nerds, moving kit. So I guess we're about halfway. Alright.
Do these have chapters on hotwiring?
Yes, she's vandalizing things in her own house. She's stupid as hell.
Asking for a friend.
Like, does she think he's not gonna know who did it?
Should fill this with gasoline just in case.
There's one fucking person who could have done it and who would do it.
Yeah.
Because there's one person probably who's a dick to him in his life.
I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first.
Where are these car repair guys?
Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for a friend. Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache. David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox.
Anime is
he
right.
He gets so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted.
Alright. We gotta give the dickhead his tools. After we vandalized his tools.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
I got the power. I'm the teenager who is drawing my arm back to not give you the thing that you want to take. I hold the power.
See what's up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
That was such a stupid thing to do.
You could be good at this. If you lost the attitude.
Is this what raising teenagers is like? Like, when I have kids, David. Is this what I'm gonna have to go through? Because I'm gonna be sad.
All right.
This is gonna be like, why do they suck? They're shitty people. Yeah, why isn't she a car lesbian? That's what I've been saying. Oh my god. That's what I've been saying this whole time. Ah, what do I do? Help! Muscle car lesbian. I can't. I want to do it. I want to do it. I'm going to let the chat decide. Place your votes. Oh god, I'm doing
fine.
It.
Fine, whatever.
Y'all took too long to vote. I waited for as long as I could. I made him wait long enough.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Whoa! You calling me a dick? Oh god, how many dick jokes are gonna be made about this character?
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Ignore anger.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me? Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
That was crazy. All right, so I wonder what kind of crazy shit we're in. Oh my god, the music. Jesus Christ. Is this pre-rendered?
Country music? Dad loved this song.
This socket wrench. Did you see it?
I just called.
Country music! She's gonna jump out of the car and commit suicide.
What
just
a
you
beautiful
wait.
Day.
Oh my god.
This isn't right.
Did she just sing that this in a...
This...
She's singing!
This isn't... This... This... This...
Someone sample
this,
it.
This,
quick, I'll play it a couple
this,
more times. Get it.
This, this... This, this, this.
Okay.
This isn't right. I know what a spark plug does, jerkbot.
I know what a spark plug is.
If Mom were here, she'd tell me to turn the junk off. This, this, this.
Dad, turn it up.
Is he singing? Oh my god. Look out, Tails, you're gonna crash! Oh my god. I'm in pain because of this crazy episode, Jesus. I'm glad there are two eps.
The hell?
I'm not gonna be able to do the second ep, probably. I don't know.
I don't know how much time I have. I might have enough time. I don't know. Let's see.
Shit.
I'm gonna be thankful, because he's a nice guy. He's not that bad.
I can see you rolling your eyes.
No, it's not.
I was actually
They outsourced this to another company. They're working on two, though, thankfully. But it's not Don't Not. It's... I don't even remember who it is. Probably worth looking into, because they suck.
Hello, Black Hell.
I think they were given, like, the rough outline and told what to make and given, like, access to the assets. I don't know how much of a hand Don't Not had into it, but I know someone else developed it. It's my foul! Telltale. Choice. Wait, am I supposed to push a button to go or something? Or is it just gonna... Is this some Lynch shit? You know? Who cares how long the take is? Is it the Battle Royale flag? I don't think I'll ever stream story mode again.
Hey, Elliot.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking...
I hope y'all like my new sarcastic laugh.
Do you want to go together,
Mom? I don't know if
tomorrow?
It's too much. Oh god, I don't really want to. Look at him. Look at that face. Look at that expectant face. Let's leave him in suspense for a little bit. Cue up the Jeopardy music. Do 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 do. All right. He's gonna tell
him. No way. I'd rather have my eyes gouged out with rusted forks.
Yeah, right. Me too, I guess.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
That's what that built up to was crazy. Look, he's gonna cry.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
I've been trying to be nice, but I couldn't... I didn't want a
Nathan
Warren situation
tights.
Happening again, because I hated that shit. Except I made Warren get into a fight, and he got the shit kicked out of him.
How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance?
What is this poster? Why is she just holding her face? Is that supposed to be because she's messed
How
up
could I possibly make
or
it
something?
A day in this place without
if anyone
a
knows, please let me know in the chat.
Well, at least not for
How
now.
Could I possibly make it through another day? All right. Oh my god, I thought there was a wall. Hey, it's Skip. We gotta talk
Skip
to Skip,
Matthews,
the security
Black
guard.
Girl's finest. He's not so bad for a mall cop.
What do we got? Oh, we have a new... We have some new pages. Where are they? Okay. Max. You know how things with Mom seem like they couldn't get any worse? Ha! The sad truth is, I suddenly have to choose between being nice or being honest with her, because I can't be both. But how can I keep being nice and pretending like she didn't make a horrible choice with Mustache? Kiko, man. Oh. Maybe I'll bring Hikikomorian back. Who knows? God, I'm starting to feel the effects of the alcohol. Okay. But how can I keep being nice and pretending like she didn't make a horrible choice with Mustache? And why am I the only one concerned about this hostile takeover of our house? Today it's a toolbox and pot roast. Tomorrow it's I should stop there for sanity's sake. When did she write this? Like in the car? Was she just like hiding it from Mustache? Like, oh, I'm writing in my... we got these nice drawings. She's a very good drawer for drawing in a car. We got Honesty Villa Niceberg. And yeah, I know Mom is stressed about money issues, but that still doesn't justify her horrible taste in men. Also, Mom knows I've been skipping, which sucks, but in a way it makes me feel better about it. Does that make me a bad person? That I don't feel bad about fucking off, just relieved that I don't have to waste the energy to lie about it anymore? On second thought, don't answer that. Chloe, the no good, very bad person. All right, we got one more page, and then we got some bio and a text. All right, Max. So the mustache drove me to school today. Yep, that's what my life's become. Look at this drawing of her past. This is ridiculous. Even worse, he thought the ride was like a tell me how things are going to be from now on opportunity. You'd be proud of me. I kept my mouth shut like a good little girl or a good little serial killer. There's more than one way to skin a David. I had a dream about Dad again. The one where I was there when it happened. It seems to get harder and harder after each of these to remember what's real and what's not. All I can remember after I wake up is how much I miss him. I hope that never goes away. The Chloe who wasn't there. Or was I? And then we got this Arcadian nonsense. I don't know. She's creepy and weird. Okay. We gotta learn about Elliot. As far as Blackwell students go, Elliot Hampton is pretty not terrible. He hangs out with some of the douchers sometimes, but I get the sense that he's mostly a lone wolf, like this chick. Similar to my class schedule, Elliot and I have history, but no chemistry or drama. We hooked up a few times shortly after Dad died, but there wasn't really much to it. I think I was just bored or maybe a little lonely. Weird, I know. I don't always get where Elliot's coming from. He's constantly asking to do stuff with me, which is nice, but I'm not sure we have that much in common anymore. Sometimes when we talk, it almost seems like he's studying me. I can't tell if he actually wants to be friends or just get in my pants. I guess I should be flattered either way, but I'm also not sure how much I care. Sorry, Elliot. And there's this weird drawing. Sup. I'm a weirdo. Alright, now we just gotta learn about Mikey and Steph. Does that say cool something, bro? Cool story, bro? Is that what his shirt says? Oh, God. Has kissed girls and has not kissed ... ever. What a loser. I can never tell if Steph is the coolest or nerdiest person in all of Blackwell. Maybe both. She's definitely queen of the indoor kids with all their weird role-playing games and sci-fi shit. I guess her dad is a video editor. She makes some sweet cash by selling bootleg DVDs. Don't knock the hustle. And I'm pretty sure Steph does all the backstage tech school stuff, bro. The cool backstage technical work for the school plays, which checks out. Another thing for Steph, she's into girls and she doesn't give a shit what anyone else thinks about it. Possible romantic interest? Mikey North is the captain of Steph's fan club, and the two of them can be found huddled around tables rolling 20-sided dice wherever they have the chance. If life were one of those 80s movies Dad used to watch, Mikey would be the nerd that the jocks give wedgies to. In the real world, if someone messed with Mikey, they'd be in deep shit. Mikey's older brother is Drew North, Blackwell's alpha jock. Six. You rolled a six, so you're sixth level. You get the flaming gauntlet of awesomeness. I guess that's what that's trying to convey. I don't think she's ever played D&D. The truth is, Mikey is one of the few genuinely nice people in this place, although every once in a while, he says something that reveals a darker outlook for life. No idea where he gets it from. Maybe Star Trek? Alright. This is lame shit. And then we've got our new text from Steph. Alright. Oh yeah, the DVD. Hey, I'm at the picnic table with Mikey. Thanks, on my way. So we're gonna meet them. Alright. But we gotta talk to this guy first.
Hey, Skip.
We gotta figure out what he's about.
Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today. I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
So, I went to the mill last night. Caught Firewalk live.
Yeah, I can see that. Wait. You went to the mill last night?
It was cool.
Kiss button.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
What, like good music?
Preach it, sister. I'm in a band, actually.
No
shit. My God.
Really?
We're called Pisshead. It's not a big deal or anything. I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but...
Dimmer?
It's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
I'm trying to get my demo out there.
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Yeah, let's listen.
Okay.
Where is it? Shithead! Where is Shithead? Oh my God, we get to listen to this shit. Yeah, I'm breaking out my bass. I'm gonna jam along here.
This song sucks. The depth of peel on that ladder was killing me. It's a good time to pee, if you need to. I'm gonna look at Twitter myself. Cause we gotta jam this. This is part of the content of the game, you know? I have no idea. It's like a 6 minute long song. I don't know what's wrong.
So, what did you think?
Can I say it sucked?
I mean, I didn't really get it.
That was great.
Oh, yeah, it's weird or whatever. We're still trying to find our sound.
Hopefully he never makes music again. What an idiot. That O was pretty good. What's Miss Grant?
Miss Grant. The least lame teacher at Blackwell.
What's Miss Grant?
Wish she could get over the whole push me to succeed thing, though. Morning, Miss Grant.
I remember Miss Grant.
What do you think of this
actually,
hypothesis?
Actually, vaguely, I think.
That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today.
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late,
that expression was too much.
I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good. But instead of going to support more science
and mathematics,
Grant will
remember that.
It's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly.
You have to have the dot, dot, dot.
I recently made a case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad.
All right.
Look at it this way, Miss Grant. More art classes will keep all the smug, self-absorbed types out of your science classroom.
Articulate, as always.
Oh, I can probably get Shithead to play it again so you can get a sample real quick. Real quick. It's very important. Skip would probably love to show it to me again. Oh god, there's another line.
So,
okay, I guess he won't, but I can ask
Justin's
him this.
Mom?
That's important. Yeah, but Shithead played his demo tape and it was,
but if you see Justin,
the worst song I've ever heard.
Tell him I can only ignore that cloud of weed smoke for so long.
Tell him yourself, Skip. Not my problem.
I'm trying to do him a favor. Speaking of doing people favors.
Yeah. Guess I've been hanging around Justin this morning. His odor must have latched onto me.
Uh-huh. Glad to see all you high risks sticking together.
High risks?
Oh, shit. Sorry. Forget I called you that.
Huh. High risks. Guess you can learn useful things in school. I've got to get to class. Let's talk later, Skip.
Sure, Chloe.
What's this dialogue? Can I ask him about it?
Stay out of trouble.
Not. Okay. Hey. Wait. Hey, let me out.
Stay out of trouble.
Let me out. Hey, let me out. Okay. She writes it on her hand!
Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
We gotta take a gander here. What are we missing? We've got this sign, we've got a crate.
Huh. Weirdly, that makes me interested in walking on the stage.
What's gonna happen when I walk on this stage, y'all? Is the game gonna ban me? Am I gonna get banned from VAC?
Oh god. Okay. Oh, I can sit and think about life. My favorite times in the whole game.
Should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care.
Is this it? Is she just gonna? Does she have any other?
Last night really happened.
Okay, she does.
The internet says it did.
There's content, y'all.
I still can't believe it. Rachel Amber. The drama star, honor student, popular princess of Blackwell, swoops in like Batman to save my ass and crash to Firewalk? Either that was a dream or real life just got a shit ton crazier.
Is there anything else? You got anything else to say to us? I don't think so. All right. Writing on my hand so people can ask me what's written on my hand all day.
Principal Wells. God.
I pissed off the principal.
Stay cool, Chloe. You've got a marijuana flavored bag of expulsion in your pocket.
Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
I'm sorry about that sarcastic laugh bit. I need to stop.
I swear to you, I did not walk on that stage. It was more of a saunter.
Do I look amused to you?
I don't know. I've only seen you with one expression. That's the one.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero tolerance policy. And yet if my olfactory sense does not fail me, I'd say you've recently been exposed to marijuana smoke.
Shit.
Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price?
Am I going to start the insult game?
I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
I'm tempted. I'm so tempted to just say no, but I know it's not going to end well.
All right, sir. I'll see you after school.
It gives me time to get rid of it.
I'll count the minutes.
That guy's a tool.
Okay, it seems everyone's cleared out. I gotta go get my DVD, and then we can head on inside, I guess. I gotta piss so bad. Does anyone else need to piss? Did y'all get your pissing done? This is that dude.
Steph and Mikey normally post up somewhere quiet in the courtyard.
Alright, hang on. I'm gonna pee really quick. I'm gonna go as fast as possible. This is what happens. This is the price of the magic here, you know? You drink 3 beers. Alright, so y'all get this. I just got the Steam Link in the mail. I got it because a Black Friday sale had it
They had it for sale for like 10 bucks or something like that. Sorry, I lost track of what I was talking about. But yeah, it's here. I'm holding it in my hand. So I'm going to open the box really quick and look at the thing. And then I'm going to go back to playing. The box is really nice. Doesn't seem like I paid what I paid for this. Okay. Let's see. Valve killing it with their... with their Steam Link. No, I'm being ironic. I don't know if they're killing it or not. I haven't used it. Okay. Seems like a cool little device. Has the Steam logo on it. That makes me happy. What else is in here? Got a quick start guide. And what else? I bet there isn't a Steam controller, although that would be amazing. Those were on sale too, I should have gotten one. Alright, almost ready. I'm sorry. So many seals. Alright. Really nice looking power adapter. Holy shit. All of this is really nice. This is a cool package. So yeah, I ain't gonna plug it in anytime soon, but that exists. It's pretty cool. Alright, let's continue. Okay, do we have anything new to say to Elliot? Okay, nothing. Alright. And what about... oh, is that our old friend? Let's look at the fountain really quick.
The future needs excellence.
I hope y'all enjoyed all that teasing of this object you'll never get to look at. Maybe during episode 3 I'll
Victoria
show it to you.
Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her.
Victoria Chase.
Oh, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, Carrie. Right. I'm just X-Thing. Teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Teleports further away from her.
You hang with the Vortex Club?
I mean, I'm technically not a member, but I am being courted.
I'm not sure
the club should be a collection of Blackwell elites. But instead, it's some anti-bullying, hand-holding kumbaya shit. Not when I'm a senior.
What about Rachel Amber? What do you gotta say?
What about
this
Rachel
even
Amber?
Came with a
Rachel
sick Ethernet
a
cable.
Selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about
the
Rachel.
Girl with the dead dad.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
Oh my god, this
so
is...
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber.
Ridiculous, I hate it.
That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh god,
I apologize if I'm being obnoxious. I don't know how to react to this. It's crazy.
Being you. Oh.
This came with a bunch of weird power adapters, and I don't know what any of them are. Alright.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course. That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and, uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey! Thanks, Carrie!
No problem.
Fuck Victoria. You dumb idiot. Look at that stupid walk, like, ha 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 ha. I wrecked that kid. And it's like, ha ha, actually, I wrecked you. Okay, who is this? Justin Bieber. We gotta look at the skateboard.
What does that say on it? Navy jazz? Navy jazz? What does that say? Indie?
I bet Steph and Mikey are playing games on one of the tables. I can tell Justin's wearing his eau de gange.
Hey, price check. Gotten in any good trouble lately?
Price check?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow, no shit. I thought that place was like Meth Central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. It was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand.
What? Hey, you wouldn't understand? I'm
question,
sure this guy would understand probably better out of anyone
Rachel
there.
She is amazing. If you're into
chicks
that
are
hot,
bro.
Smart, and hot.
I was making tons of NASA jokes during that whole scene. It was crazy.
Hard.
I believe you.
It was crazy. Actually, you should watch that part on the archive whenever this is over or whatever, because that part was fucking nuts.
C+.
Dude, you need to freshen like a mofo.
Are you saying I smell like weed?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Word. Well, good looking out, Price. Wanna hit?
No.
Like, right here?
This guy's a weirdo.
Thanks.
He's a hipster. Alright. Y'all see anyone else? There's the bikes. There's someone sitting by I guess we need to talk to whoever's sitting by this tree. Who are you? God, there's a lot of characters.
Samantha Myers, school wallflower. She could give you a run for your money, Max.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
The story is about how relationships only work if people are willing to lie to each other.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
Who's the bismuth of the game? Who is the bismuth of the game? That's a good question. If you find the bismuth of the game... Actually, I think we might be coming up on the bismuth of the game. This is the person wearing the cool story bro shirt. I think this is them, and I don't see nobody else around. Oh, wait, there's one. See what this person's about, and then we'll go talk to them, because they're the objective. Okay. Is this George Lucas?
Evan. Amazing photographer, but such a bleeding heart. What's up?
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
Is this the guy from LA Noir?
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues.
LA Noir is ridiculous.
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
Smoke.
Happy to support such an important cause. Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Principals, dicks, Big McHuge Balls, and Smokeweed de Bear.
Thanks so much for signing my petition. Smokeweed de Bear?
Only you can prevent ganja fires.
He's so mad. I like how the signature disappeared. Did you see that? Look, it's not there anymore. Look! Oh my god.
No, Chloe. Class is back the other way.
He erased it with his mind. Smokeweed to bear.
Steph Gingrich and Mikey North, Blackwell's premier indoor kids.
Steph All right, has created it's time for lesbian love to flourish. DVDs
to other students.
Are you ready?
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloody,
there's gonna be some
totally
kissing going
potion.
On.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
Okay, that guy isn't
One
very
Blade
busy.
Runner, director's cut coming right up.
I was hoping he was gonna be a really obnoxious
Sweet.
Character.
$5, right?
Just Keep because it. That cool story
was
bro shirt was enough, I thought he was going to be like, really, like, I'm a nerd.
Cut, took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
It's all about right that on. Final cut.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
Why do you want to know?
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes. What else have you got to do before class?
Okay. Let's do it.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Okay, I need to stop. I'm sorry.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
An elf barbarian. The elf barbarian.
Are you insulting me in some obscure nerd way?
Think about it. An elf? Like, skinny and kind of weird, but also a barbarian, so, like, really angry.
In other words,
how is that funny?
Face.
What a weird
wow.
nerd.
You two are a riot.
All right.
I hate these people.
You are both.
I was excited for this. I can't believe
Avernon,
it.
A once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, wizard
oh
of the Third
God.
Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernus.
Anyone else having a hell ride right now?
Introduce your character.
Oh, this is my character?
Yeah, okay.
I like
I'm
how they just
elf
had an elf barbarian
name.
On hand.
Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron.
This is so bad.
In the name of King Tiberius, what makes
I
you
love
think
it.
You are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing.
What was that look on his face?
To your left, the Raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgeron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The Raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Leave the game! I'm so tempted, but I'm not gonna do that.
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
God, that's such a good option, though. Just
you are spotted by a heavy set orc.
To class.
Where immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Urgul?
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave!
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks,
I'm just spacing out. This
like
part sucks.
Bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game.
It's going well.
This isn't even how you play. This
well,
is terrible.
As the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
My character raises her axe. You'll pay for ruining all that loot, Elamon.
By my honor,
that
I
shirt.
Apologize. Here, take this potion as a gift.
Thanks, dude.
What's next?
It's tent time.
We can't just leave those prisoners there.
You're right. Never pass up free slaves.
Holy shit.
Kidding. Jeez.
Where do you
Jesus,
wish to go?
Did you see that jump? What just happened?
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's
that was crazy.
Camp. You behold a field of standing iron cages.
This game
each
is a mess.
A human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a
that
small
jump was out of control.
Is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Did they add that in an update or something? Because that was really not
polished. Little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
This is
time
out of control.
To work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use...
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Everybody knows that dragons are pussies. That's why they hide in caves and only come out to breathe fire on sheep and eat cows and shit.
That was a mistake. The dragonkin growls, snapping at you and showing his teeth and claws. Tall one is a fool. Dragons are gods, he says.
Damn.
This tabletop shit is hard.
Try playing solo.
The dragonkin swallows the key, pointing at his stomach and then his own butt, laughing at you. Then he...
I shove my axe through the cage, right into his stomach. Then I twist it, and then pull it out. His guts and shit start falling everywhere, but I jam my hands inside his open stomach, grabbing the key.
This is pretty metal. Look at that expression. She's disturbed. Oh my god.
I hold the key up to his face, and then I laugh.
When you have issues and you play D&D...
Normally, I'd say you failed the challenge, except that was so horrifically amazing. You won.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed
pretty much
in a fine black cloak.
That's all that line was saying.
Sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows. Wah, ha, 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine.
They're not even your rolling dice or anything. Nothing. This isn't how you play D&D at all.
Weak.
You leave it up to chance,
you
not just,
weak.
I shove my
asshole.
Axe in the hole
I got this.
And stab.
I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
Oh, holy shit! Annihilation Strike! That sounds boss as fuck!
One?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
If I kill Mikey, that's funny.
Oh no. Three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's
Holy
leg.
Shit.
Legs. Plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
I like playing Chloe as just a complete asshole.
I told you this was my best boss.
This is funny as
you
hell.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
The controller is vibrating with every stomp.
Sort of. What should I do? I jump in front of Elmon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer... thingy.
Oh, brilliant.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20.
Fuck yes.
She gets a 1 and then a 20 the next time she rolls. This is ridiculous. No, I don't buy it.
His bracer of fire immunity clings to the ground.
That was some bad writing.
Gignomi's fire strike of flame.
Oh, snap.
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest.
Durgaron.
Incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon.
Durgaron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have Damn. Died a hero
then live as a coward.
Hard shit.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Serious? Are you serious? This is bad. I hate
Glad
it.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
Is there anything that's changed around here? I don't think so. That was supposed to be like 20 minutes before class, but somehow I've taken that and made it like 2 hours. I'm so sorry.
What the hell?
Oh jeez, I gotta put
what
my
controller in. Twitch, don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott. It's not yours. Give it back. I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa. You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop. Chloe, do something. Don't just stand there watching.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Idiot. You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
These are some great insults.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
When Nathan goes crying to Lord Prescott, everybody here will be stuck doing sensitivity seminars all week.
You want a piece of this?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair.
I like how I'm insulting both of them.
You think this is funny? You think I'm joking here?
Look. If you insist on continuing to suck so much, there won't be any oxygen for the rest
of us. Oh, I think he won.
All talk, no game, huh, Chloe?
Dang. There we go.
Booyah!
You got what you wanted, Mel.
That took me months to put together! Quit the team, Twitch. For your own good.
I like how this is a meta commentary on Twitch.tv.
Shit. Next time, mind your own business.
You're welcome.
Are you alright? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Football toss. Okay, we're finally continuing. I hate this scene. Oh, we got There will be consequences. Glad we talked. Me too. I know you're doing your best. Love you. Okay, that's sweet. And we have David and Nathan, or Drew and Nathan. Let's see. Drew North is Mikey's older brother, and the two of them couldn't be more different. Drew is a legit jock, like the kind that spends hours a day in the gym and has nicknames for his biceps. I've never been to a Bigfoot's game, but I hear he's actually really good at throwing stuff into other stuff or whatever. Basketball goes into hoop, football goes into butt, pretty sure. Wow. Mikey told me that Drew... Alright. Yeah, see you later, Mel. Thanks for watching. Mikey told me that Drew is planning to go to college on an athletic scholarship, which is good because their family is even poorer than mine. Their dad was one of the fishermen who lost his job because of the Prescott Corporation. As you might imagine, this put Nathan on Drew's shit list, not a good list to be on. In the war between a meat heat and a shithead, does anyone win? Anyway, I don't think Drew's actually a bad guy, but I guess I wouldn't know. It's like we exist in two completely different planes of existence that happen to be the same school. Happy to keep it that way. Alright, and then we have Nathan. Nathan Prescott is the golden child of the Prescotts, Arcadia Bay's oldest, wealthiest, and most powerful family, as they love reminding everyone. Nathan's dad does something nautical-related. I think it has to do with murdering baby seals and turning them into death rays for the military, but I can't remember the details. XD. Whatever the case, there's a lot of people in this town who hate the Prescotts, including all the fishermen he put out of work, and you do not want to mess with fishermen. They smell. Nathan is odd. He's extremely privileged, yet dark and brooding. Even though he's a dick, I can't help feeling bad for him sometimes. He's really just a weird little dude trying to figure out his shit. But he has to pretend to be all this stuff he's clearly not, like an athlete or a cool kid. You can tell it fucks him up inside. Of course, the best cure for feeling bad for Nathan is to actually talk to Nathan. Then you remember what a wonderfully punchable face those Prescott jeans gave him. Is there any... Hang on.
Evan's work is actually pretty good. I'd never tell him that, of course. This makes being high sound like a bad thing.
Are there any areas where we can do some graffiti or something?
What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
Otters. All right.
That pic would actually make a sweet tattoo.
This is the dumbest thing I've ever seen. All right.
Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence. And by future excellence, I mean mole people.
Oh, good. You're here.
What's going on now?
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers.
So what I missed a graffiti thing then.
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues... Hath I listened to...
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome.
This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite, Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
I wasn't paying attention.
Miranda's an idiot, because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
Actually, she's about 15, so your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive, is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Am I supposed to care about the connection between these characters? Because I don't. So, like, I mean, I know what happens in life is strange and everything,
but... Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
There's, like, nothing tying these characters together except she's pretty. Sure. It's weird.
Okay. Get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down.
Hey, now. Sharing is caring. To internet or not to internet?
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
I already read
Why
this.
Do theater kids take themselves so seriously?
Rachel Amber praying Prospera. A newcomer to Blackwell Academy, Rachel Amber blew the doors off her audition with a heartbreaking reading of Blanche from Tennessee Williams, A Streetcar Named Desire. Other interests include athletics, debate team, boosters, fundraising, local history, and nature. Rachel hopes to one day grace the stages of Broadway and the silver screen of Hollywood. And then we have Nathan Prescott playing Caliban, a favorite son of the oldest and most influential family in Arcadia Bay. Nathan hopes this performance of The Tempest will only further the legacy of the Prescott name at Blackwell Academy. Playing Caliban has been a challenge for the sophomore, who enjoys sports, photography, and casual hangouts with his many friends. We've got Dana Ward playing Miranda. A sophomore, Dana has performed in two other productions at Blackwell Academy since her freshman year. Dana enjoys football, Go Bigfoot, social media, and social dances. She hopes to be a member of the Vortex Club when she's a senior. And we have Hayden Jones playing Ferdinand. This show marks the introduction of Hayden Jones to Blackwell Academy's drama club. He auditioned on a dare and, as it turns out, actually really digs acting. A sophomore, his other interests include playing sports, herbals, and taking long walks in the woods. We've got two more, okay. Juliet Watson playing Ariel. Juliet's primary interests include journalism and social activism, but she is very excited to be debuting this spring in the role of Ariel, the capricious and powerful spirit Prospera has enchanted and bound to do her magical bidding. And we've got Travis Keaton directing. A veteran of Broadway, Travis Wilbury Keaton serves the prestigious Blackwell Academy as a teacher of the dramatic arts, mentor, and friend. He hopes this humble reinterpretation of Shakespeare's masterpiece can inspire the next generation of the country's leaders to strive for greatness and never to forget his motto, Ars Gratia Artis. And then here we've got who worked on these. Steph's the stage manager, Brooks on the sound design. All right. Prescott Foundation has something to do with this. I like how she tells me to get something and I'm just looking
this
at all this shit.
This poster definitely says something. RA will suck as Prospera. If VC had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you, slut?
Guess they don't call it Drama Lab for nothing. What to say?
Slut shaming?
Slut shaming is so 2009. VC should know.
That handwriting. Well, at least that time it actually shows it. I want to check to make sure. Is there anything else I can look at?
I guess the Prescott donation doesn't cover this. If I'd known acting meant getting to play with weapons, I totally would have auditioned for the Tempest. Should be Life is Drama. Sweet collar, Pepe.
All right. It's time.
That's the nicest backpack I've seen in my life. Rachel looks so happy here.
Does that not look like the same dad? It's like the same exact person they were drawing.
There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now. Must be 100 costumes in here. Am I the only student who's not in this show? Rachel Amber, drama star and guardian angel. I still can't believe that was her last night.
Choice.
Just keeping it real. Sometimes you just gotta turn up the heat. I'm gonna guess it's from Logan. Must be 100 costumes in here.
Yeah, we already saw this line.
Am I the only... Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So? Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
I guess I owe you.
I'll hold you to that.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Is that a rhetorical question?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Ditch class? You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or...
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right. Well?
What the hell am I getting into here?
this thing go? North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Alright, what do we got? Hey, why weren't you and Kim? Everything okay? Yep. What happened with Drew North? You sure you're okay? Yo, let's talk later. Okay. And we've got Rachel's profile now. How do you describe Rachel Amber? I've been trying to find the right words ever since we met. The crazy thing about Rachel is that I really should hate her guts. I mean, she's a straight-A student, beloved by everyone at school, including students and teachers. She's super into acting, and I hear she even does modeling on the side, which I imagine her district attorney dad and Stepford housewife mom support her in. It all sounds like a recipe for awfulness, and yet Rachel somehow is nothing like the privileged golden child type you'd expect. She's not like any type, actually. She's probably the most surprising person I've ever met. And that's not just because when we met she was helping me take down some skeevy assholes at a rock show, but it's just this feeling she gives off. Like, when you're with her, anything is possible. Not right, meow. Fuck, it really sounds like I have a crush on her, doesn't it? Here's hoping she reveals something really horrible about herself soon, like a stamp collection or a love for cat memes. Something to make her a little less indescribably awesome. This is supposed to be 2010. Hang on, we got more to read. Oh, jeez. Alright, hang on. I'm gonna BRB for just a second, take a little break, breathe a little bit, and then we're gonna finish this up. So, be right back.